Howdy guys, welcome back to Let's Play Week. Today we are taking a look at some of our farms around the area, and also some of the stuff we missed in the house last time. So I'm just gonna go ahead and finish planting down the rest of these chorus fruit. I think I got everything planted down here. Yep, nice, okay. And we should also see that over here we now have a bunch of stuff filtering into the chest, which we do, very good. I'll go ahead and put these away here. And let's go ahead and actually just sleep through the night just by teleporting up to our base and sleeping in our cozy little bed up here. So we'll just go ahead and hop on in here. And then we'll take a look at the farms and some other stuff below the house, which I didn't show you guys last time. But, so you saw the chorus fruit farm right there. We also have a iron farm. This is the iron trench by Tango. I built this a while back in 1.7. It has since broken somewhat. And I also made this little water elevator up here, which we have to actually wait until we're done with speed to actually go up this properly, because speed does mess it up for whatever reason. There we go. Okay, so yeah, you got to swim it up here. But yeah, kind of a cool little water elevator. Whoops, that sound is a little bit loud. I'm going to go ahead and turn that down just a slight bit. Turn it down just about 50% or so. There we go. But this still does work, but not as well as it used to. You can see here we have bunches and bunches of iron and also somehow gunpowder in there. That's a little concerning. But yeah, that is the iron farm. It still, like I said, sort of works, but I do need to update it. That's one of the things I've needed to do for quite some time, like a ridiculous amount of time. So that's that. We also have an automatic sugarcane farm here. This thing is fully automatic. Requires no player input whatsoever. I actually have a bud that is powered by sugarcane underneath of this, which harvests this, and it's pretty cool when it harvests. It goes boom, 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 all the way up. All the sugarcane gets popped off, put into this water stream, and then flows down this direction on where it's collected underground. And I'll show you the collection for all these farms as well, all these automatic farms. Over here we have the melon and pumpkin farm. It's a pretty straightforward design. It's just like a little 3x3. There's daylight sensors underground, which harvest this every day. You can see some of the torches going up here on the side. And we got some little banners in here. Pumpkin and melon banners in here. And again, I'll show you the collection area for this. Here we have our automatic wheat farm. We have a villager here whose inventory is totally full of seeds. And yeah, basically he goes around harvesting all the mature wheat, which he's doing a pretty good job. I don't see any mature wheat right now, so he's doing his thing. And of course, there is a hopper minecart underneath, which drops everything off here. Yep, there he goes. Yeah, look at him, patrolling the area like a boss right there. Over here, we have more villagers. Over here, we have carrot farm. I hear a zombie somewhere, which is a little concerning. Oh, right here. There we go. Got him. All right, so yeah, we have a carrot farm right here. And then this is sort of a stacked farm. So then we have our potato farm up here. We got a bread farm right here. You see him there harvesting, replanting. Pretty good farm. And then we got a beetroot farm at the very top, right here. So, yeah, kind of a cool thing. You can see some of the beetroots there, just sort of sitting there. He goes and picks those up on occasion, and then tosses the items into a water stream, which then drops them all down, and they're all collected by a minecart system, which I'll show you in a moment. So let's go ahead and just get down here. So those are the food farms. That's how I get all my potatoes and carrots that I trade away into a bunch of emeralds and stuff. Out here we have our fireworks display. So this is a fully automatic fireworks display. Well, not really fully automatic. You just have to flick a lever and it plays. But basically, underground here we have a lot of redstone, which leads to a lot of dispensers, which we can use in a fireworks display. And I think we're actually about to pass... We're almost at 9,000 days, so we might have a fireworks display for that. But basically, it's a front-loading system. You put your fireworks right in here, and you'll see there's a bunch of them hidden in here in the stone and everything. And yeah, this is also... here's some in here. I can actually show you how this works. It's kind of cool. So I'll just go ahead and put a few of these in here. But basically, what happens is basically you just sort of front load this, just put a few of these in here. And yeah, you heard some redstone stuff going on there as I loaded this. So I'll just go ahead and load this up real quick with just a few things, just a few fireworks. Put a few in there. Let's put some in here. Looks like there's a few left over as well, which is cool. There we go. So there's a lot of these dispensers around here. And basically what happens, basically the first fireworks that shoot out, these fireworks, they have to be totally empty before it triggers the grand finale, which will be in these dispensers back here. So I'm just going to go ahead and put a few in here. Like that. And we'll put a few in this one. Put a few in here. A few in there. And a few in here. Like that. And of course, let's put a few more over this way as well. Just to sort of show you. Don't want this to be too long, but want you to get the general idea of how this thing works. So this actually makes sure that every firework is actually fired before triggering the grand finale. And the way we do that is through a bunch of redstone. And also, this cart is actually hooked up directly to our fireworks crafting area in Zerzera. So that's kind of cool. Let's see, is this one full? No, I'll just put a few in here. We'll put two in there. There we go. Again, you heard some redstone down there. So that is that. And we might have one or two more here. Yeah, that's good enough. Let's go ahead and show you how it works. So we'll come over here. All you gotta do is flick the lever, and it works its magic. And so usually this doesn't take too terribly long. So there we go. We started it. You see a couple fireworks going up. Daytime fireworks. This time around, basically. So it randomly fires at different speeds. So it's like a real fireworks show, basically. Nice, slow, methodical pattern. And then there it is. Grand finale goes up at the end. Occasionally there are some stragglers. There's a few stragglers around, but for the most part it's pretty consistent. So that's the fireworks display. And yeah, of course, now with the new crafting recipe in 1.10, you now get 3 fireworks for every one you used to get before. So it's a lot cheaper. So that means we'll do more fireworks in the future. So pretty cool. This giant mushroom here, this is a giant mushroom I completed a long time ago. This is actually a mushroom farm inside of this. So if I were to break into this, you'd see mushrooms growing. About every, I think, two Minecraft weeks, this thing gets harvested. So water flushes everything down. And again, there's a collection system, which I'll show you underground. Here we have a standard chicken farm. Pretty straightforward design here. You got your lava right here to cook chicken. You got your water here to drown chicken. These babies grow up. They drown or burn in the lava. Their item gets put into the chest, into this chest, and then goes down to a collection system, which I'll show you once again. Let's see. Here we have a rabbit farm. The way this works is, yeah, we breed the rabbits up right here. The babies all drop down through the fence, and then we translocate them via this button right here to this quadrant here. And yeah, you see we got some rabbit hides in there. Basically, I think all these guys are grown up. Yeah, it looks like it. So we'll just translocate them over. They are now located here. And then we just go in, hit them a few times, and that should pretty much drop all their items. There we go. They're all down. And there come the items right there. Very nice. Cool. And pretty much you want to use the looting 3 to get the most drops from these guys. But I didn't have one on me at the moment. But yeah, that's basically how that works. To breed them up, all you have to do is hit this button and then just hop up here and obviously make sure you're full on food as well. But yeah, you just pretty much, you know, do the basic breeding thing here. So yeah, just do this. Just gonna walk around, make sure we get all of them here. It can take a little while sometimes to feed them all and breed them all up, but there we go. And now hit this button. There the babies go down to the, excuse me, to the ground. And yeah, we just wait for them to grow up now. So that's that. Over here we have a standard cactus farm. Many of you guys probably know how these work. Pretty standard stuff. We got a banner here as well. But yeah, this is also an automatic farm right here. And the collection is right down there. Whoa, Nelly, hello. Did not see you, sir. Greetings. Greetings. There we go. Got that one. All right. This one is a cocoa bean farm. It's a sort of a jungle jungle log theme farm. We have the cookie banner up here as well. All you gotta do to harvest this, hit the button, pick up cocoa beans. So pretty straightforward there. I'll just go ahead and pick all these up right now. And then of course, you know, plant it down. Pretty straightforward, you just plant them back down on the tree. So it's kind of cool. It's pretty well hidden, which is nice. So it's not, it's pretty aesthetic farm. So it's pretty decent that in that sense. So that is that. I'll go ahead and plant the rest of these later on. Coming up here, we got our sheep on the loose. Don't know how you got out, guy, but it's the last thing you do. What the heck? What the heck's going on here? We got a bunch of sheep that have somehow escaped. Red sheep escaping, white sheep escaping, all the sheep escaping. So these are my sheep farm. My sheep farms, I should say. We got every color of sheep represented here. We got some mixing here. We don't want that. We want the purebred, pure sheep right here. There you go, guy. I'll let you go since you walk. No, you can't. You can't go back in, guy. I'm sorry. But yeah, we have every color of sheep represented here. Basically just a manual sheared farm, although I have a design for a semi-automatic farm, which I should probably start to build here soon. But yeah, and then we have storage over here, so I have a bunch of wool stocked up from various projects throughout the years. So there we go. That is that. Let's go ahead and sleep here. I'll show you a few of these farms out here. So out here, you can see, first of all, some more wool farms down here. These are the rest of the colors. And also we have the impossible powered lamp still going strong after like 3 years. So yeah, nothing is connected to these. There's no torch on the backside of this block. It's just wood. And yeah, you can't actually do this anymore, to my knowledge. Well, you might be able to. I take that back. I bet you probably can somehow. But yeah, you can see another example right here. These lamps are permanently turned on, and they don't actually have any other external source of power. So as long as I don't update them, they will stay like that forever, which is pretty awesome. Next up, we got our cow farm here. I've heard that this has actually broken, but I don't really believe it. So basically the way this works, we have ourselves a lava blade here. We also have some dispensers down here for potions. Basically, we just hit this button, and the cows burn right here, and they should all die here. Yep, and then everything flows into this chest, and then to breed these guys up, all we have to do here is hit this button. Let me just get some wheat here. So we flick this lever, that block comes out. Hit this button now. That brings out the water, basically, and then we just take our wheat. Hold down, right click, and it breeds them up. Breeds up all the cows into baby cows. So yeah, just like this. And then once we're done with this, you just simply put the wheat away. Put the wheat away here. Flick this lever, hit this button again. You see it basically punches all the babies out. And now we just wait for them to grow up. So that's how that works. What up, sheep? RIP. So yeah, that's pretty straightforward there on how that works. Let's go ahead and put some of these in there as well. And dump some of this stuff off. There we go. And yeah, down here, like I said, I just have the rest of the wool colors and the appropriate banners. These are supposed to be like sheep head banners, basically. It's fairly close. It's fairly close for a banner. And speaking of banners, I also want to show you guys the banner creation room in the house. But first, this is the pig farm. Pretty straightforward pig farm. I think this still has some problems, but I'm gonna try it anyway. Let's see. I think one of these dispenses lava and one of these dispenses potions. I think this is the potion one. Yeah, this is the potion one. We're running low on potions, but yeah, there we go. And this should, yeah, have the raw pork chops coming in. Very nice. So yeah, basically this works through baby pigs' hitboxes being smaller than normal. So if I just go ahead and breed up these pigs here, just like this, and if I then open this, usually, well, that didn't used to happen, but basically the baby pigs can walk through the pistons, but the normal size pigs can't. Come on, guys. This is a demo. You're ruining the demo. Get in the farm. Dang it. So yeah, that's the idea. So we should see some baby pigs falling down here. Perhaps. Let's just see. Let's draw a few down this way. Draw them over here. They should be walking off now. They should all go down to the bottom. Yep, there you go. So we got some baby pigs down there. And these guys now grow up. And that's basically how it works. And we also have the lava blade that comes out if I hit this button, which kills the adult pigs, but not the babies, because they're small enough to not be killed, I think. They might have changed that, though. But yeah, I need to sort of upgrade the pig farm, because, yeah, you saw the translocation glitch caused a little bit of problems with the pig farm. So that's something I need to upgrade. All right, so that's the farms out here. We also have a snow farm right here. Got a little snowman on here. And basically this thing is a really efficient snow farm. We got our snowman in there. He's on an enchantment table. And then basically all we have to do here, we got to fill up our inventory like this. Make a slot for the shovels. And let's see, this may or may not have the necessary equipment here. Nah, it doesn't. But basically what happens if I turn this on, we just spam right here. It drops the snow down, and you'll hear a click here in a moment once this next cycle goes through, right there. And that is a dispenser underneath us that gives us iron shovels as we go along. And then basically, yeah, the snow falls down, and basically it's collected underground here. And yeah, that's basically how I get a bunch of snow at once. This is to put shovels in and stuff, so I need some wood here, which I don't have at the moment, but it's a pretty efficient snow farm. This is designed, I think, by Doc M, and I just made like a ice spike out of it right here. And then the collection area down here, we got this whole collection area down here with the water streams basically feeding into these chests. So yeah, you can see there's some snowballs down there. So yeah, it's an easy way to get a bunch of snow. And this is actually almost full, so I might need to consolidate some snow here. But that's the snow farm. Let's see. Somehow snowballs came all the way out here. Just get rid of these. There we go. Over here we got a horse pasture farm. You can see some weird stuff over here. Like this whole area here looks kind of weird. It's because Endermen are grief in this area. This area is not very well lit. Yeah, you see Enderman grief right here. Look at this damage. Good lord. Enderman grief. Let's repair this, actually. Bang. There we go. Problem fixed, baby. So this is where I keep most of my horses. We got some cows here as well. But I need to do some repair work over here because the Endermen, you can see, are taking blocks from this area like crazy. Look at this. Look at this. This used to be flat ground here. That's crazy. But I keep a lot of my horses here. We also have a nice stable over here where I keep the horses. And yeah, we have some donkeys and some mules around here as well. They're sort of just hanging out over here. But that is what that is. If we go ahead and make our way into here, you'll see the inside of the stables. Got some different horses here, some armor on them. And yeah, we also have some stats for these guys. Yeah, the speed and the jump height of each horse and or mule. So that's pretty useful. We also have a horse testing facility, which you guys will see later on. And yeah, we just have a little stable area here, and you can see a couple more horses down there. Plus some, you know, horse armor and saddles and stuff in here. So that's that. Again, I'll show you the horse testing area a little bit later on. And let's see. Finally, here we have a tree farm. Sort of a tree farm. It's not really much of a tree farm, but yeah, this is it right here. Basically, the way it works is you cut down the tree in here, all the leaves decay, and then everything, like the saplings and the apples, fall down into these water streams. At which point they are all collected up down here. So you can see some saplings and other things, other apples and stuff down there. So it's a very basic tree farm, but it works for me. Although I do need to make it automatic. And I also need to make one on Hermitcraft too. So yeah, I need to upgrade some stuff around here still. I'll go ahead and eat something here. I want to show you this. This is a invention of mine here. This is the sort of automatic quad portal, I guess, is how I sort of describe it. So basically, the idea is that, let me see if I can get this to work here. There we go. The idea is you come up to the portal and it's like this. It's off. And all you got to do is simply walk over this pressure plate and then this one. It lights all four portals, as you just saw there. So all four portals around me are now lit. And then you go through to the nether. Then when you come back, you step over this pressure plate and the portals go away. So it turns on and off. And I have pressure plates to do that, although I can maybe change this now to redstone ore. Because, yeah, you can sort of detect when you walk over redstone ore now with daylight sensors, and it's much more consistent. But that's for another video. But anyway, that's the quad portal I got. And then over here we have Villager Trading Center. So this is a pretty good Villager Trading Center. You see we got a lot of high level books, mending, efficiency 5, Frostwalker, protection 4, ton more mending books. And I get all this via librarian trades. You see I have sort of labeled all these librarian trades based on, you know, what they offer here. So yeah, I do quite a bit of trading here, villager trading, and yeah, you see a bunch of junk here, iron, rotten flesh, etc. And basically how this works, I have a lever here that controls the spawning of the villagers. Let's see, it's down now, so spawning is on. And basically, the villagers come up this water stream, go over here, and then each individual cell I can sort of toggle. So basically, if I go ahead and just break this, for instance, I'll show you. So right now, this is closed off for some reason. Shouldn't be closed, but basically, if I hit this button, the villager will drop down, and this should open up, although it's not opening up for some reason. That's weird. Need to look into that. But basically what should happen, let's see, is this guy any good? Nah, he's no good. So basically we will just, we'll drop this guy. So it dropped him down. He goes away to a place that we shall not mention. And then the thing above him opens up, so the next villager can then come down, drop in. So that's basically how that works. These chests here are just to store extra items and things to trade away. And then, let's see, down here is where the villagers actually breed up. So if I just drop on down here, you'll see there's a couple of, wow, this is overpopulated. But yeah, this is where all the villagers breed up, and I need to probably cull them right now. But that's gonna have to wait for now. You're lucky. I'll be back, though. And basically, I just go in and kill a bunch of them, and then, yeah, it starts up again. So yeah, that's where I keep the villagers down there. And I have to have this gap here because otherwise it's not considered a village. But that's how I get all the villagers there. So I think that's most of the farms in the immediate surrounding area. We do have a lot more farms in the distance, in the far regions of the world, which I'll show you. We also have, you know, some farms up there, which we'll get to. But first I want to show you guys the rest of the house, the underground of the house right here. So, actually, you know what? I'll show you guys the collection area for all these farms. So basically we have the automatic farms we have the cactus farm, chicken farm, mushroom farm, bread, carrot, potato, wheat, melon, pumpkin, sugar cane, farms all connected up. I'm just going to go ahead and sleep through the night here as well. And basically we have a minecart system that collects everything automatically for us. So if I just go ahead and make my way over here, we're going to sleep real quick just to show you guys what we got. So give me one second here. There we go. Beautiful. So we'll make our way down here. I want to show you this real quick. This is actually a real-time cart tracker that I made. So basically this shows me where the minecart is that's collecting things at any given time. So you see it just left the cactus farm. And it's going to go to the chicken farm. So now it's collecting things at the chicken farm. And basically this is a representation of... So this is like the house here. These are all the various farms around here. So it just went from the chicken farm. Now it's going to go to the mushroom farm. So this light will light up. So, yep, there it is right there. It left the mushroom farm because there's usually not too much to collect there. And now we are going to hear it go right overhead. Think maybe, and yeah, it ended up at the sugarcane farm. I guess we didn't hear it. We can actually go and see this right out here if we make our way down this way. So basically, it's just going. It went from the cactus farm to the chicken farm to the mushroom farm. Now it's over at the sugarcane farm behind our house. But basically, yeah, it's a huge minecart network down here, and I went into the wrong hole, didn't I? Dang it. This is actually the next hole over. Yep, right here. And so, basically, yeah, this is basically a system where there's a bunch of logic down here that determines where and when the cart travels to and from different areas. So the cart should, it's good, the cart is down here now. This is the sugarcane farm, though. Basically, the sugarcane comes down, the cart collects what it can here, it then launches from here, makes a test to see if it's full enough to return to the, or if it can actually pick up any more items. If it can, then it turns and goes down to the drop-off point and restarts the cycle. If not, it goes down this way, which is where it's at right now, and picks up more items. So it's somewhere down here. Let's see if we can find it here. It might be... Yep, here it is. Cool. So yeah, we can see it in action here, actually. So let's just see. Yeah, so this is what it's picked up so far. And it looks like it has a little bit more to go here. But once this runs out, it's going to recognize that there's nothing else to pick up and launch automatically. So here we go. It's going to launch. Any moment now. There we go. Dun, 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 dun. It's going to make a determination if it's full or not. It's not full, so it goes to pick up more items down this next track. So now it's at the wheat farm. Picking up some wheat. Let's see how much wheat is there in there. Not too much, so it's picking up a little bit. And then basically if this thing runs out, let's just simulate that. It'll make another determination, test if it's full or not. It's not, so it goes on to the next one. And I think you get the idea. So yeah, it's kind of a unique system. It's very complex. A lot of redstone down here. This is actually something I custom designed myself for this. So yeah, kind of a cool thing. And then I think one of these, I think this one maybe? Or no, this one right here. This is actually, well, maybe it's this one. One of these basically activates the lights to let us know where it's at. So kind of a cool system. I never seen like a real-time cart tracker like we have here. So I'm pretty proud of it. And yeah, there's more logic down here with the real-time cart tracker. This basically just goes across the ravine here. Back to the mushroom farm, cactus farm, etc. This is just the other half, basically. And I sort of made like a little fallen tree thing here for this whole thing. So, yeah, kind of a cool thing. Kind of a cool thing. Let's just get out here, and we should now see that this is at the carrot, wheat, and potato farm, which is where it spends most of its time. So, yeah, you can see on the real-time car tracker there, we got it at the carrot, wheat, and potato farm now. So, yeah, it's kind of cool. And then after it's done collecting stuff there, once it gets full to a certain point, it will automatically launch itself back, dump its stuff off, and then all that stuff gets sorted automatically through our auto sorter. So, very powerful system here. Very powerful system. So this is sort of underneath my house, the starting underneath my house. So let's just check this out now. Down here we have the bar area, which is what this is. So, you know, we got food that is usually dispensed from here, although it looks like we might be out. Oh, there we go. We got some steak. Very nice. We got ourselves a pool table right here. You got the billiard sticks on here. We got the billiard balls in here. 2-ball, 5-ball, cue ball, etc. Right in here. So yeah, I got a full set of billiards right there. This is just basically like a lounging area down here with the Minecraft world around us right here. So yeah, kind of cool there. Over here we got the redstone testing area. This area has some history here. This is basically where I run some tests on redstone stuffs. And we also have some cool stuff in the wall, like these pistons and these lights will occasionally turn on and off. Depending on, yeah, where some chickens are. You see that one just retracted there. And, yeah, kind of a cool little area here. Also, this is made out of all redstone ore. Down here we have the Rainbow Ravine, obviously. I just decided one day to, yeah, make this into a Rainbow Ravine. So this took quite some time to make, actually, but turned out pretty cool, I think. Kind of a cool little, like... aesthetic here, and it goes on for a little ways, not too horribly far, because yeah, it takes a while to get all this clay, but yeah, it's kind of cool. It's like we got ourselves another visitor. Don't blow up, guy. All right, we got him. Oh, that's it. All right, we'll see you in the next one, guys. Hopefully you're enjoying Let's Play Week, and I will see you guys in the next video.